Do you want to quickly and easily create documents that you can send to your customers to sign? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to create, send, and manage your legally binding documents in just a few clicks. To get started, we're going to go to jotform.com and come over here to products and select Jotform Sign. Now, Jotform is best known as an online form builder, probably the easiest and most powerful builder on the market. And that's great when it comes to document signage, because really what we're talking about here is a type of form, but we also want to keep track of what is happening. And yes, Jotform Sign is free for up to 10 signed documents per month. Once you've signed into your Jotform account, our first step is going to be to come up here and select Create Signed Document. Now, you can upload any type of PDF document to start creating your signed fields, or you can come over here and select one of the 600 plus ready-made templates. So regardless if you are creating a bill of sale or a rental agreement or some other legally binding document, chances are you'll find a template here. But let's go back and show you how easy it is to upload your own PDF. So here I'm going to upload a document. I have something here called a certification form. I'm going to select that. I could add multiple documents at a time if I wanted to, and I'm going to say create signable document. Now, what it's going to do is not only just upload the document at this point, but it's also going to try and detect those fields. You can see here at the top of the screen, it says detect fields automatically, and we are going to say yes, detect those fields. Jotform Sign is now going to analyze this PDF and see if it can identify all of the fields where we need to sign. And it's done a really, really good job. You can see all of these blue highlighted areas where it is going to allow the user to input information, whether that's a student number, whether that's a checkbox, and of course the signature and date details down below. Now, I'm going to say keep all in this case, but if there happens to be a few that are missing, no problem. That's where we can go and add our fields here on the left-hand side of the screen. So it didn't capture this phone number here. All I need to do is drag this phone field over and drop it in. Let me just place it here, and maybe I want to space it out just a little bit so it fills this entire field. And then on the right-hand side, I can make some additional options if I want to. If I want to change the field label here, or maybe I want to make it required, I can make that option here as well. Really, Jotform Sign gives us a number of advanced options. So for example, if I only want to accept phone numbers that match a specific format, I can choose that here, and other advanced options as well. In this case, there's one other field that wasn't captured here. No problem. I've got this little plus button. It recognizes that it's probably another checkbox. Let me just move that up here so that it is in line. And perfect. Now I've got that option here as well. In this case, I'm going to want to add what that last option is. It is the change of visa status or other. And this is going to be very important. What I love, of course, is that Jotform Sign has already put in all of this text for me. I've only had to add this last one because it didn't quite catch this last checkbox. But remember, regardless of what you upload into Jotform Sign, all of these fields are now customizable. Now, at the very top corner of the screen, we can always go and preview our document. Let me just toggle this switch, and it's going to show me what this is going to look like for the person that I send it to. Now, at first glance, you may say this doesn't look very different than what we saw on the other screen, but let me show you one of the key benefits of using a service like Jotform Sign. Here you can see if I decide to click in the last name field, rather than entering it directly into this blue shaded area, it's actually going to prompt me for my first and last name, even though the order of the form is last and first. What I love about this is that it's making it a little smart, because we're so much more used to entering our name first and then last. I can hit next, but it will correctly put it in the right place. But these smart fields make it even easier for the recipients who may be accessing or receiving this document on a mobile device. Let me go to the phone preview just to show you very briefly. Now, of course, the field itself is going to be quite small because, yes, it's a PDF PDF document. But no problem, I can't read these checkboxes. If I start to click on any of them, I am brought up with the full field, which makes it so much easier for me to select my options. I'm going to select next. Yes, my major is going to be a commerce degree. And yes, my second major is going to be in the arts. So I don't have to be constrained by zooming in and out of this form. It makes it that much easier for me to fill out this form regardless of the device that I'm viewing it on. Coming back to our editable form, we can also highlight who is supposed to sign or fill in which fields. In this case, you can see that everything has a shade of blue. But if I scroll down to the very bottom, there's an academic advisor's name. Let's say in this example, that is me. I don't want the student to fill out this information. I don't want this even to be available to them. Well, all I need to do is click on this field, and down below, you can see that it's currently assigned to signer one. But if I select this dropdown, I can say, no, I want to assign that to me. I'm going to go to this next signature. I'm going to make the same change assigned to me, and the date should be assigned to me as well. Now you can see that we have a different color indicating that this portion is for my signature, my input, but everything else will be up to the student. And of course, you can have more than just two signers. You can have multiple signers and put them in a specific order. When we are happy with editing all of our fields in our form, we want to next come up to settings. Here we can give our document a specific or different title than the one that you uploaded. You can also come up here and customize your email settings. So the default subject will be your signature requested for the particular form. And I can add a custom message down below as well. Lastly, you can set up specific integrations. So if you want your signed PDFs to go directly to one of your favorite third-party cloud storage systems, you can do so right here. So if there's a particular folder in Google Drive, Dropbox, OneDrive, or many others, you can have those signed PDFs go directly to that location. Lastly, we want to come over to the Send tab, and here you can see the different recipients. Now, I'm of course the me, that orange shade. Here is my name, and here is my email address. But who are we going to send it to? Well, in this case, I'm going to send it to a test account. Let me input that email address here. And now you can see I have signer one and then myself. But we can also customize these options as well. So for example, it's going to make the most sense in this form that the student, signer one, signs first and then I sign second. In that case, I want to select the signing order where signer one is number one and then I will be number two. If I need to rearrange this, it's as simple as dragging and rearranging that order here. But in my case, I want to go back to that original order as we see. We can also select on the options tab to set an expiration date. We can also send automatic reminder email. So if someone doesn't sign that document right away, you can choose how many days or maybe even every day that you'd like to remind them until they've signed that document. And now that we've double checked all of our settings, we can select send to sign. Jotform Sign will then show us exactly when the form was sent and which signers have been included. But remember, I won't receive the document just yet, not until the first signer has completed the document. Now within the Jotform Sign inbox, we can keep track of all of the forms which we have created and sent out and also see what the status of those forms are. For example, here you can see that waiting for others, we have the document which we just sent out 3 minutes ago. So here I can see that I am waiting for this individual to sign before I can add my signature to the document. You'll notice that I don't have anything waiting for me just yet because I need this individual to sign the document first. Here at the top of the screen, we can also make selections such as canceling the document or sending additional email reminders if necessary. But let's jump to our email inbox and see what the user experiences. Here within my test account, I've just received my invitation to sign that document. Remember, this is the inbox of signing number one. If I open up this email, you can see it's clear and straight to the point. And of course, I can customize this message if I like. By clicking the button, it will open up the Jotform Sign viewer where I can quickly and easily start filling out about this sign. Jotform Sign will also try to bring in relevant information, such as my first and last name, which is already populated, and today's date. So there are just a few less things that I have to worry about when filling out this document. Once I've filled out all of the required fields, I can come down to the bottom of the screen. Here I can fill in my name, then add my signature. Now, of course, I can either use one of the defaults here and change the style or color, or I can choose to draw my own signature as well, if that is preferred. And now I can choose that date if I need to change it, otherwise I can stick with the default. When I'm all done, all I need to do is select Sign and Complete at the top of the screen, and by accepting and send, this is a legally binding document. And now, if I jump back to my Jotform Sign inbox, you can see that waiting for others has nothing, but now there is something waiting for my signature. And yes, here is the form that the student just completed and filled out below. Now what I can do is proceed with signing this document. At this stage, as the second signer, I can choose to review the document and then add my signature down below. And as you saw, when we set up this form, I only have these three fields available to me. So I can add my name here, and then I can add my signature. Let's just go with that one there and say accept and send. Back within the Jotform Sign inbox, I can see the completed document with both signatures and also see a full audit trail and document history. So when the invitations were sent, when they were viewed, and most importantly, when they were signed. So if you'd like to collect e-signatures quickly and easily, be sure to check out Jotform Sign by clicking the link in the description below. And if you'd like to learn how to create your own free mobile app, be sure to watch this video on the screen right now. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.